Hi, today I want to talk to you about what to do on the first day of working out, tips for men and women over the age of 50. Before we hop into this video today, I want to make sure that you hit that subscribe button and that little gray bell next to it so you can get updated with all this great content because I make this specifically for you. Who am I? My name's Brian Stecker, and I'm the owner of Boomer Fitness, a gym here in Vancouver, Washington, about the last 8 years. And I've been a personal trainer for the last 16 years. So I help baby boomers like yourself make transformation. First of all, when you're going to the gym, working out for the very first time, I want to congratulate you. It's surprising how many times there's some sort of fear that prevents somebody to come into the gym for the very first time. And what do I mean by that? Is for some of my male clients, it's performance issues. Maybe they're afraid they're going to look bad on a certain lift. They're not going to do something that they used to do before, and people are going to judge them. For some of my female clients, they're just scared to come to the gym. They feel like people are going to look at them. There's a number of times where, you know, I've had clients tell me before they signed up for the gym and start in the gym is that they went to the parking lot, they parked in the parking lot, and that they never came in. I even at one point got an email from a lady telling me that if it was okay, or asking if it was okay to come into the gym. So let's hop right into this video so far. The first thing that I recommend clients before starting their first workout is knowing what their goals are before beginning a workout program. Because if you don't have a target, you're not going to hit it. So what I would do is I would get a piece of paper and a pencil, or a piece of paper and a pen, and I would write down specifically what goals do you have. And goals are usually SMART: specific, measurable, attainable, realistic, time-bound goals. So say you wanted to lose 10 pounds in the next 6 weeks, I would write that goal down on a piece of paper and I would look at it maybe every single day. I would look at it every single week. So that way you know what that target is for you. The next thing is you gotta know why this goal is important to you. Why is this important to you for achieving the goal? And ask yourself that question. Why is this important to you? Because a lot of times people say, hey, I just want to fit in my clothes. I want to feel better. That's a good start. But usually the clients that I've worked with in the past, those goals aren't enough to sustain them and move them forward. So by asking yourself the question, why is this important to me? You're going to get down to the emotions or the core values of why you want to achieve these goals. Maybe it's to have longevity. Maybe it's to play with the grandchildren. Maybe it's to have better health, to live a longer life. Those are the reasons that are gonna sustain you to make sure that you hit that target. All right, the next thing you wanna do is you wanna schedule it. Like you do anything else, and you wanna block that in your schedule. So like, If you have time set aside every day at 7 a.m., just put that in your schedule for 7 a.m. and nothing is going to interrupt it, all right? Make that a schedule and focus on putting it in there so nothing else interrupts it. Some days you're gonna do 20 minutes, some days you're gonna do 30 minutes, some days you're gonna be motivated, you'll be there for the full hour. But by scheduling it, you'll make sure that nothing can interrupt it. So just do your best. You're not gonna be perfect every single time with it, but if you have in your schedule, you're more than likely going to hit it. You know, your schedule when starting out, I usually get asked, well, how many times should I go to the gym? And for when it comes to resistance training, I would focus on 2 times a week for the first 6 to 8 weeks to build up your conditioning if you haven't worked out for more than 6 months. If you've been working out for more than 6 months and you've been doing it at home and going for walks, bodyweight workouts, some light strength training, doing some 5Ks, working on a pull-up progression program, I'd work on getting to the gym 3 to 4 days a week. Now, the most important thing now that you're in the gym is to have a workout plan. And there's plenty of them here on the Boomer Fitness website. And I'll link some of them here at the end of the video of where you can start. I'm gonna assume your goal is weight loss, move better, and get stronger, or build a little bit of muscle. So you need to have a plan. So how you want to approach starting your plan is you want to begin your workout with a dynamic warm-up. What this is going to do, it's going to warm up your central nervous system, and it's going to help you with your balance, and it's going to prep your body for movement. So that way you don't get a strain, tear, or a pull, all right? And then you're probably like, Brian, well, what exercise do I do next? What I've seen, we just finished up a challenge, a 12-week challenge, and we finished up a 6-week challenge here at Boomer Fitness. And I can tell you this, is if you're starting out, these movements are the same for everybody, and there's just progressions to them. And you wanna start off with compound lifts. And sometimes people in the comment section tell me, well, like, I can't do a deadlift. Well, I can't do a squat. There are progressions for it. So my bootcamp clients who finished up a 6-week transformation program, and a few people lost over 30 pounds, another few lost 20 pounds, and multiple people lost 10 pounds. I'm not saying that you're gonna get those results or I'm promising those results, but those people did these same moves and they had progressions to it. So your workout routine should be built up of, say, squats, your deadlifts, your lunges, bench presses, pull downs, and then find the progressions that work for you. So if you can't do a squat, I would start off with, say, a progression that you've seen on some of the videos I've done before of like a TRX squat. And then if you can't do a lunge, I would do a wall sit. If you can't do bench presses, I would do push-ups. And if you can do those exercises, great. I would start with those. Usually what I would start off with is I would start with 3 to 4 sets of those exercises. The intensity that you want to work with on a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being like, this is really easy, like it's a walk through the park, or 10, it's like extremely difficult. You want to feel like it's about a 6 or a 7. What I would do then is I would just set aside 30 to 50 minutes and I would just work through those exercises repeatedly till that time frames up. So what that could look like is, I'll give you an example of a gentleman that I just started work with. We would start with some TRX squats and we would do 12 to 15 TRX squats. And then for this gentleman, he needed some rest afterwards. So the nice thing about resistance training is you can work at your own pace. And then he took about 3 minutes after those squats. In between that, we did some stretches. Then we went to the next exercise, which we did some push-ups, okay? And we did some push-ups from a progression. And that progression was from a Smith machine where the bar was across some support. And we did about 15 push-ups. Rest cycle was about, I would say, 90 seconds to 2 minutes. And then we progressed over to a light box step-up. All right, we did 15 to 20 on each leg, and then we went over and we did a seated row, and we did 12 to 15 repetitions, and then we did a few core exercises, and then we repeated back to the top until we completed that for 50 minutes. Fast forward a couple weeks, this gentleman has then progressed by increasing his range of motion, his endurance has went up, and we started adding some weights for that. Another great thing you want to do when beginning out is you've got this wonderful phone here, is you can keep some notes in there, or you could just use some old pen and paper. The great thing about the notes is you'll have a clear plan of what you're doing for your workout that day, but you can also start writing down things of how many reps that you completed, how much weight that you use, how much time you use per set, because with workouts, a lot of times you've heard this probably a million times, is you want to focus on progress. You want to focus on progressive overload. And a lot of people, when they hear that word, they think to themselves, oh my gosh, I've got to push myself at a super hardcore level. But what progress is just doing a little better for yourself. So for that gentleman, he started off with TRX squats. We did that for a couple weeks. His range of motion, his conditioning got better. He told me this exercise was too easy. And then we progressed into some body weight squats. The push-ups, we went from the Smith machine supported down to the floor. So by keeping notes like that, you can progress every single workout. So that way you don't plateau and you continue to make gains. From there, when you finish your workout, you want to go have yourself a nice meal. And a nice meal for some people is a protein shake. It's easy to digest after the workout and gives your body the nutrients to recover. What does that look like? It'd be 20 grams of protein for a female, upwards of 40 grams of protein for a guy, and usually about the same in the carbohydrate realm. Or it could be a chicken breast if you eat some chicken with a half a cup to a cup of brown rice. If you're a vegan, you can have some pea-based protein with a carbohydrate source also. So have yourself a nice meal afterwards. And then what I want you to do is I want you to personally celebrate what you've done that day. Again, when people start something new for the first time, they tend to be difficult or hard on themselves. What this is going to allow you to do is reinforce the positive changes that you're making in your life to have a healthier lifestyle and to have a better life. So there is my experience from my 16 years of being a personal trainer, 8 years of being a gym owner. A couple bonus tips for you is you can start giving yourself some motivation. Again, you got this great phone. You can put a great playlist in there. Spotify does a great job with that, or you can make your own Apple playlist. Make sure you bring a bottle of water with you. When you're working out, you're losing about 6 to 8 ounces every 15 minutes, and you want to be able to replace it. So have yourself some water for yourself, and then bring a towel so you can clean up after yourself. If you like this video, make sure you give it a like. And then lastly, last but not least, the hardest part to keep something going is to have your own level of motivation in the beginning. And that's why our clients here at Boomer Fitness and my online transformation clients, they get some personal accountability. And what is that accountability going to do for you? That is going to be somebody who's going to check in with you every single week to make sure that you stay on track. They're there to answer your questions. They're there to challenge you. They're there to make sure you're making progress so that way you can make it a sustainable lifestyle. If you want that accountability for yourself, I've got a few spots in my transformation program. Down below in the top pinned comment, you'll see a link to my schedule. That's where you and I will hop on a phone call and we'll go over your goals, find out why it's important to you, what your challenges are, and then we can figure out if it's a good fit. If we work together, what the call is not, it's not putting a plan together for you to achieve those fitness goals so that way you can go start that. That's about you and I working together to make sure that way you've got the accountability and support to reach those goals. And again, down in the comment section, let me know which one of these tips that you thought was most helpful, because and or topics that you want to cover in upcoming video, because I make these specifically for you. And I look forward to seeing you in the next video. Have yourself a wonderful day.